Well, as far as I'm concerned, it's a matter of pot calling the kettle black. The Senate, I'm sorry to say, they are not in the right position considering their antecedents as highly corrupt individuals who know only nothing but about their pockets. They have no right to reject Magu. Because I'm sure even if Magu is corrupt, Senate's corruption is 100 times more than Magu's own. At least that even a layman knows. So the Senate and the DSS, as far as I'm concerned, they are working hand in hand. President Buhari is trying to foment an anti-corruption agenda. But the corruption is an institution in Nigeria. You have to, to fight corruption in Nigeria is not by handling individuals. It is by going to the root, which is the system. It's a systematic thing. And let me be honest, it's a Herculean task for President Buhari. Because the people, the individuals involved from the institution, to start uprooting them, it's a lot of work. So there is nothing, no matter how much he beats that door, it's a massive iron door. He's just putting some dents. He's not really opening the door.
My own reaction to rejection of Magu by Senate is really unfortunate. Are they better than Magu? Most of them are corrupt. So rejecting Magu, it means they don't want Magu to probe them. They should be the one to be rejected, not Magu. That's my point.
I think Magu is just a child of circumstance or like a scapegoat in the mix of the wide of corrupt people in administrative positions in Nigeria. Magu's case is that, first of all, the 8th Assembly is a conglomeration of about 22 past governors or so. And these 22 past governors are governors that have issues with EFCC as we speak. So you already see that there's an indication that these people will work against the interests of the acting EFCC chair. You understand? And by so doing, they are putting all pressure to make sure that the guy is not confirmed. Now, we learned that there were two reports that even came in from the DSS, again, trying to say that he does not have the moral rights or is not fit enough. You know, it's not, he has failed integrity test, so to speak. Dino Mela is leading the proceeding yesterday. He said, Magu ought to be like Caesar's wife, ought to be above board, must be unblemished, must not be tainted. He used a lot of languages that one, you begin to ask yourself that who is Dino Melai and what is he saying? Who are these senators in the 8th Assembly? What are they saying? The Senate President, who is even under investigation of the EFCC and the tribunal, the CCB, CCT, who has been caught by the web of that on terms of a false asset declaration and all that. So these are people that have come together that now have the moral rectitude to discredit someone. I mean, Nigeria is really in a very big problem.
But what do you have to say about the DSS being the one to say Magu lacks integrity when Buhari is nominating Magu?
I mean, that's the conflict, that's the confusion, because DSS is an extension of the presidency, okay? And the EFCC is also part of that arm extending to defense. So now you see that there's just a conspiracy, you understand, to make sure that this man don't get confirmed, because there's an indication that if he gets confirmed, there will be a very serious trouble, because most of the people in the National Assembly, if they make that, now they are telling us that it's their oversight function, that they are performing the oversight function to say the man is not credible. But I want to say that is not in the interest of the larger society. In as much as at the risk of not speaking for Nigerians, I would say I have tested the pulse of this society on this issue, and I think that most people are with Magu. But the Senate, you understand, have taken a very dangerous side on this issue, because if you look at the excuses that he has a relationship with some other persons who were corrupt, therefore that is just it. So he's corrupt. He's not transparent. He's living beyond his means. and all that. I mean, is there anybody in the National Assembly that's really living within their means? Is there any governor in Nigeria that is living within what they earn legally? You understand? I'm not saying corruption should be justified. I'm not saying corruption should become the article of faith in Nigeria. But I'm saying that those who tend to nail this man, are they also clean? Do they have that moral right to do? Therefore, we should begin to, the Nigerian society should begin to watch what the Senate called their oversight function. Civil society is supposed to be the fourth arm of government that should also even checkmate what the Senate, even though we have donated our allegiance to them to act. But I think that what we do not see as oversight function, or what we do not see that they appropriate, they should not begin to, they should have even consulted the civil society, you understand, on this issue, because it's not just that they are speaking our minds. I don't believe that they are speaking the minds of Nigerians as a political. And the other part of it is that we should also look at it objectively, that if that sails as well, some people might say you are speaking with the two sides of your mind, but that's not true. If that has sailed as well, I also think that it's not only Magu that is competent to handle that position in Nigeria. If we want to go by what the Senate they are saying and all that, if it's anything to go by, which I don't think is even credible, but we can also have someone who is upright to do the job, who can still go after all those people who are corrupt, the people who are stacking money in different places and all that, violating the essence of Nigeria and creating serious economic injustice in Nigeria. We can go after them with someone else if Magu cannot fit in the position. But that is not to say that the Senate have done their oversight function. It's not an oversight function.
You see, if they are going to discuss, I don't think people in the Senate should do that. And why they are doing that is that they know there is corruption even among themselves. You understand? And there is no way, because this corruption, is very high in the Senate, and that is why the high profile there, we want to do everything to fight it. If not, corruption should be something that everybody will embrace, especially our leaders. If our leaders cannot embrace the fight against corruption, then what are we talking about? It is high time that if they are serious and they want to fight against corruption, they must show us by example. They must try to inject corruption from their midst. Then we know that we are ready to fight corruption, because it is those at the top that can start it first. Of course, it is clear. You must know there are manipulations. You understand? And like I said earlier on, these people can do anything. So they are going to do everything to manipulate the system, to so that it can favor them. You understand? They do everything to manipulate the system. Like I said earlier on, the DSS had no moral justification to say Magu is this thing is corrupt or something like that. Let's fight against corruption. You understand? Those in the DSS, they are human beings as well. They are subject to manipulations. You understand? And Nigeria this day, we don't care. What you just care about is that let money go, exchange hands. And that is our problem. But until we are able to stop all this nonsense and say, come what may, I don't want to stand with your money. I stand against corruption. That is when all this issue can be stopped.
What I know about Nigeria is that Senate and other people, they do themselves. Actually, there's a secret behind that man. That's why they are rejecting it. Maybe they don't want to expose the secret. But I know that they know themselves. That's why they are rejecting it.
No.
They are the same thing. All are the same thing. Okay? All are the same thing. They are just fools. Fully, those who are people at a low level. They are foolish. They know themselves. Maybe Magu never said to them. Maybe they never said to them. Left and right. Okay? You have to balance it. Doesn't make the balance. That's what they are rejecting.
No, it's not that I'm saying he lacks integrity. Well, he might be a good person in other side, but if you look at the position he wants to be nominated, you see that probably I would say that he might not be capable. But for the Senate to have decided not to let him be in the post, you see that probably they've done enough screening and they believe he might not be fitting for the post. But let me say, already Nigeria is a corrupt country, we all know that. And for the Senate, we guys are clamoring for change. We are all demanding change. But if the change will begin, it begins somewhere. So if you want to say something about the Senate that yes, they are corrupt, let me just say yes. But it has to start from somewhere.
His rejection is in good faith, but unfortunately, you cannot use corruption to fight corruption, because right from inception, Magu has been with then, right from the time of Noribad to the time of Lamode, and now himself. So he cannot tell us that the whole problem that happened, including the trouble that had to do with accusations that was against Lamode, that he was not there. If he was there, he should have done something about that Lamode something. He should have investigated Lamode and have come out. Up to now, from reliable and available information that I got, that Lamode is back to the police, he's working, and nobody investigated him. So it brings to the fore the question that is being asked, that is the corruption being fought by the Buhari administration a one-sided fight? Why is it that? Is it those whom he likes, who crosses to his party, or who are his cronies, who are from his own region of the country, that he fights? I, for one, I love Buhari. But the truth must be told, that if you want to be seen doing, if you want to do something, you must be seen doing that thing. If you don't want to do such a thing, you must not be seen in such arena at all. So, to paraphrase the issues concerning the present EFCC acting chairman, that he's not been confirmed, he's in good faith. But unfortunately, the truth about it all is that those who sat to think of his, of accepting him, are even having matters in the court that has to do with corruption. So even they themselves don't have the moral justification in coming to bring somebody or confirm the present EFCC chairman, Magu. So the both parties are wrong. You cannot use Satan, cannot cast out Satan. That is the truth about it. Well, the DSS is under the presidency, and Buhari is in charge of them all. So if you look at the principles of the separation of power, the Montesquieu's principle of separation of power, you have the executive, you have the legislature, you have the judiciary. Of a truth, the judiciary, both the DSS and the EFCC, they are under the president. So if the same president, the same presidency that nominated somebody is the same presidency that is saying that person is not qualified, then that brings to the fore the question of, is the presidency working antithetical to its own self? That is the question. For me now, if I answer the question is, yes, it is working against itself, because the DSS and the EFCC are under the executive. So that is a big question that leaves much to be desired. And that question should be answered.
I'm asking if you think Buhari is still in charge of this government.
Well, I wouldn't say no, that he's not in charge of government. Since he's properly represented, I would say he's still in government. He's still in government. But there's a difference between one being a leader and a leader being in charge. Do you understand? When the reign of power leaves the hands of a leader, automatically we'll just say no, that he's not in charge. You understand? If he's in charge, the things that happen shouldn't have happened, because the same presidency cannot work against itself.